coming to you, and we invite you to come into one of our services to bring glory and honor to God's name, to raise up a supernatural army with signs and wonders and miracles. Can you be part of this move? In Jesus' name, and everybody say amen.
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 Hallelujah.
My eyes are on you, and it is well. So let it go, my soul.
I've been wearing a necklace for many years, a 50 caliber bullet, he said, when I was in Vietnam, went through my helmet, grazed my head, and connected the back side. And he started telling me how his back was broken, and all this and that, and he's got these, all these different things. And I said to him, right there, I said, I want to ask you a question right now. Oh, he said, was you ever in service? I said, yeah, buddy. 82nd Airborne, perfect, same outfit as you. He said, I said, I want to ask you a question. If that bullet would have hit you in the head and killed you, and you died in Nam, where'd you went, heaven or hell? He said, to hell. I said, if you die right now, or Jesus come back again, where'd you go, heaven or hell? He said, hell. He said, I know the Bible. My father was a Pentecostal preacher. And that man stood there and quoted scripture. And I lit into him and called him a chicken and everything else. I told him, I said, if you'd have been in my outfit, I said, I'd shot you through the head. He said, why? I said, because you can't be trusted, buddy. I said, if you let that little thing of sin whip you, I won't want you in. Come on, talk to me. He said, I got to go. He went up around and kept looking back at me. I thought, scared the hell out of him. How many of you would rather have Brother Humphrey come talk to one of your thick-headed loved ones and just reel him out than to say, well, Jesus loves you. He knows all this stuff. How many of you know sometimes you just have to tell it as it is?
Right. Amen.
You know, that's what the Bible is. It tells it as it is. If my people are called by the name of the humble self of grace. That's it. But if you don't, hell bound, baby doll.
That's right, they mind.
Elijah said, there, fear not, go and do as I have said, but make me thereof a little cake first.
What?
Elijah, you want her to bake you a cake before her and the kid? Make me one first. See, he knows something's going to happen to her. There's a blessing in disguise coming.
Amen. Amen.
The widow, or the woman gave the mite. Oh, Bob says she gave the mite. She gave all her life, two mites. Gave 2 mites all her life's earnings. She didn't have enough. And Jesus said, she gave more than y'all. You cast an abundance of what you had, but she gave her whole life's earnings. How many of Jesus submits to it?
Amen.
How many know she blessed Jesus? We don't know her story, but I guarantee you she got blessed. Mm-hmm. My sister can tell you about our mom, the most generous woman on God's earth. And dating it to this day, I don't know how we lived. We lived on ground hogs, and we lived on fried potatoes. And when Mom got her little bit of a $20 check, she got some flour, a couple of things, and made us each a little loaf of bread. And how we lived, I don't know, but Mom always had something sitting there for us. So say amen.
Amen.
I know that God supplied. But she'd give it away. She'd give it away. But my mother was a blessed one. Fear not, go and do as I said, but make me thereof a little cake first, and bring it to me, and make for thee and for thy son. What? If you don't have a little bit, how do you expect me to make for them? Come to multiplication here. Say, Lord,
I
want my multiplication.
I want my
reward. So say, hallelujah. For thus saith the Lord, the God of Israel, the barrel mill shall not waste, neither shall thy cruse of oil fail, until the day that the Lord sends rain upon the earth. Wow, how many want to hear that blessing? Everything you have is never going to fail. Somebody say, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say, it's not going to fail. This week here, I had $100. And I spent, got gas and all kinds of stuff,
And we're up by Willa here yesterday, and I had $70-some. I said, where did that come from? Someone say amen.
Amen.
I don't even know what I got, but I've been living on $100 all week long and been buying all kinds of goodies and things. Someone say hallelujah. I think that five, six, seven. Oh, I know there's a whole bunch of it in there. Someone say hallelujah. A bunch of tens. Someone say hallelujah.
There's
been multiplications coming. Someone say hallelujah.
Amen.
I watched my gas tank go up. My God.
That's right.
It's not normal.
Supplies all my needs.
And if you're the son and daughter of God, then you take after God, so you're not normal.
Amen.
Look at somebody and say, I'm not normal.
I'm not normal.
Say, my God's not normal.
My God's not normal.
He's supernatural.
David said, I shall not want. How many of you know want means lack?
That's
right. So say amen. 15. And she went and did according to the saying of the Lord. How many of you know that's so important? She went and did according to the saying of the Lord. And she said, and he and her house did eat many days. They ate for many days. Until the drought was over. It was for 3 years. Go ahead. And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fell according to the word of the Lord, which he spake by Elijah. Go ahead. It came to pass after these things that the son of the woman, I'm going to stop right here. How many of you know when God gives you one miracle, get ready for another?
Ooh, yes.
I don't know if anybody heard that.
Amen.
God don't show you one miracle. He's going to show you miracle after.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
You know why he does that? To let you know he's a miracle worker.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
That's why we have a sign of signs, wonders, and miracles. To prove that he's a true and living God, to bring glory to his name and make believers out of all believers. We're going to hear that widow woman say this in a couple minutes. I remember back in 1914, God gave me a miracle. Oh, that was something else. What he's done since? Oh, I don't know. I've been having a horrible time. But 1914, I remember God testifying our church one time. He's in the First World War. He gave me a miracle, got me out of the foxhole. What's he done since? Did God die? Was he shot? Come on, talk to me, somebody. He's new every morning.
Amen.
Come on, new every morning.
Yes.
He talks to us every day.
Amen.
Amen. What are you praying about Israel for? I heard you praying. You can't bless unless you bless Israel. How many of you know that's what this ministry is?
That's it.
Yes.
And it came to pass after these things that the son of the woman, the mistress of the house, fell sick. And his sickness was so sore that there's no breath left in him. In other words, everybody say he died. My God. How many of you ever said, when a horrible thing's been coming your way, why when something else comes your way? But you know what he says? I just want to show you another miracle. I want to use you to show this world miracles.
Yay.
How many of you know he's got to use his people to prove he's real?
Amen.
Do you know it confuses doctors? Like Chester Trace ever have all this cancer over? And they sit on reports and all this and that, including myself and different ones, and they see all this kind of stuff, and then they go back and it's gone.
Ooh, yes.
So say amen.
Amen.
Now you see it, now you don't.
Now you see it, now you don't.
Hallelujah.
I heard Charles Capp say that, I guess his little girl came in and she said, Dad, God told me something. Fear knocked on the door, but faith answered.
Yes.
And fear was gone.
Yeah.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Living by faith in Jesus alone. Trusting and confiding in his great love. That sounds pretty good with a deaf ear. I didn't know how it sounded. and no breath in her. And she said unto Elijah, what have I to do with thee, O thou man of God? Art thou come unto me to call my sin to remember and slay my son? How many of you know she knew she had sinned through the years? How many of you know you've sinned through the years? Now has God come to require payment, give you reward? This is what she's thinking. What's going on? Why does this stuff happen in my home? Why is my son dead? Why? See, your God's a miracle worker. He got ready to show his hand one more time. This is why the Lord told me years ago, he said, tell the people all around the world, teach them these words. Don't thank me for what I've done, but thank me for what I'm doing and what I'm going to do.
Amen.
How many of you know he's still doing things right now?
Hallelujah.
He said to her, give me thy son, and he took him out of her bosom, she's holding, and carried him up into a loft where he abode. Where's she at? He's living in the attic. He's living in her attic. How'd you like to have a man of God living in your attic? So say amen. In those days, it wasn't like a man of God. It was like God living in your attic. How many of you, she's going to be above you?
That's right.
I think I'd say that. Lord, I'm going to move to the basement. Come on down and take my good bed. So say amen. I'll carry him up in the loft where he abode. Back up. You're doing good. I don't know why God loves you, but he does. Hallelujah. 19 is what we look for. Okay. Where he abode and laid him up on his own bed. So what did he do? He got the boy, took him up in the attic, and laid him on his own bed. My mother, when she died, Mama just laid her head back and died. They gave her up in Israel. What year was that? 1980, 81. And they said Mama never lived until she lived all the years, perfect heart. No, this is a total miracle in all itself. And I got to witness to Goldmeyer and the whole Israeli staff and all them. Dee Dee did too. But Mom, when she died and they sold that house, I said, whoever walks into this house, someone say hallelujah. Devils are going to tremble. Someone say hallelujah. How many of the anointing is on you? Come on.
Amen.
And he laid him over his own bed, verse 20 now. And he cried unto the Lord and said, O Lord my God, hast thou also brought evil upon the widow woman whom I showed journey, who I'm living, by slaying her son? Verse 21. And he stretched himself upon the child three times. The dead boy's laying there, he stretched himself upon him. How they do? Eye to eye, mouth to mouth, nose to nose, and breathing into that kid. Three times. You did it once, nothing. You did it twice, nothing. Three times. Sometimes you got to keep. You know what Smith's Wicked Reverse used to do? Take those dead people and pick them up and throw them against the wall and they'd drug their heads. I said, live! And they. Who taught him that stuff? He just knew there was a place to go. Come on, talk to me, son.
Yeah, amen.
Amen.
Why aren't we doing? There's no excuse. Just that you sing a song, ain't nobody's fault but my own.
Yep.
And said, O Lord my God, I pray thee that this child's soul come into him again. Go ahead. And the Lord heard the voice of Elijah, and the soul of the child came into him again, and he revived. Go ahead. Elijah took the child and brought him down out of the chamber, out of the attic, into the house, and delivered him to his mother. And Elijah said, see, thy son lives. for it. This is where we're going to close at. What's our slogan say? We're here to raise up a supernatural army of signs, wonders, and miracles to prove who the true living God is, to bring glory to His name, and make believers. How many of you know you need signs and wonders and miracles in your life?
Amen.
To prove that your God is God.
Amen.
Say, I need to prove that my God is God. With signs, wonders, and miracles. And the woman said to Elijah, now by this I know that thou art a what?
Man of God.
She said, now I know you're a man of God. I know you're a man of God. Why? You got to prove it in the pudding. And that the word of the God is in, and the word of the Lord is in thy mouth. So say amen.
Amen.
When it's all over and done, people are going to say, by this I know that you're a holy woman, a man of God, that your God is God. If we can't say that, something's the matter with our life.
That's right.
73, whatever I'm, what am I? Whatever. I guess 38, 39 years saved. I complain to God a lot. I say, what have I really done in all these years? Oh yes, I know. Getting raised 3 times, and every time a hill in cashers and crippled and blind and. But how many know it should be a regular day thing? Am I making any sense to you?
Yeah.
It should be every place we go. He didn't say do this inside the church. Go ye in all the world.
That's right.
Well, we're just going to have a prayer meeting tonight. Well, that's good. That's real, real good. But what are you going to do after the prayer meeting? I'll go home, pray, and say a good night prayer. Then what you going to do the next day? Well, I'll go to work, and I'll see people, and I'll pray under my breath for them. What else you going to do? I'll just pray. Get some bonus. So say amen.
Amen.
Just because we're satisfied with our Christian experience does not mean God is. How many of you know what he told me when it came out of China?
Right.
We're like the Pharisee. I fast twice a week. I get tithes off, so I have. I thank my God I'm not like a publican. I speak in tongues. What were you speaking tongues for you?
Sure.
You really hear me? So you speak in tongues. I'm discussing with Jimmy. And guess whose fault it is?
Jimmy's.
Remember back here, I'm going to close with this show. We're going to pray for some of you. Back here about a year ago. When I had that dream and I seen the granite steps clinging to heaven. I went to clean up in the clouds up in heaven. And a white bearded man in a robe came out. And I knew it was President Father Abraham. And when he came out, a whole bunch of us men and women were standing there, but probably about 12 men and one woman. And he started to preach to us, tell us things about Jesus. I can't remember what they were. Then he came down like halfway. And he's still talking about Jesus. He wanted to get closer to us, really. And when he did that, all the men preachers looked at him and turned and walked away. And the woman preacher, she turned and walked away. And I'm standing there looking at him. And then I started doing, like, well, they walked away, so I started doing because they did. And he screamed at me. I mean, screamed at me, I mean loud. Don't stay in his garden! And that brought me around. I screamed back at him. What should I do? And he screamed back at me. You know what you should do. And I dropped to both knees. Threw my hands up. And I said, I know what I should do. You know what I knew I was supposed to do? Fasting and praying to seek the glory of God and go into the heavenlies. Have I? Oh, I've been doing in part, but not as much as I should. How many know that's my fault? Tonight, I went out to the bathroom, went out to the vehicle, presented myself before God. I said, I live and move and have my very being in you. I can't live, we can't live, we can't move and have our very being except through Him. If you don't build a house, the builder does it in vain. If you don't anoint me tonight, God, it's all in vain. But I totally give myself to you, whatever you got to do with me to bring glory to your name and for souls, do it. We've got to become more serious with Him. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And you wonder why we've had every devil hell hit us?
That's right.
Stick that song on Jimmy Fire. I want the seven ladies, come, six ladies right now, come and grab your chair. Turn the lights down. Turn it up.
For Upper Room Ministry. You can see the rest of this message each Sunday evening, your local time. If you would like to receive our monthly newsletter and know the things the Lord is speaking to Prophet Humphrey, then please send a love offering to help cover our expenses. Also, if you would like to have an anointed prayer cloth and become a ministry partner, send us your picture so we can pray, lay hands on you and your need, and expect signs, wonders, and miracles in your life starting today. You will never be the same. Our website is upperroomministry.net. If you would like to schedule a speaking engagement, contact our ministry. All glory to Jesus. Amen. Amen.